everybody, it's a brand new football. Bring your hands to your face and smell the leather. Real quick, what's better? Working on a paper or throwing a football with your friends? Smelling it, feeling it, yes. So if you see Penny in the quad with a football and you know she's supposed to be working on her paper, you're not going to say, "Penny, you're lazy. You're bad. You're not motivated." You're not even going to say you're procrastinating. Because procrastination is a word psychologists use because we know we're not supposed to say bad and lazy. But it serves the same linguistic purpose. The purpose is to shut down a conversation. And you can feel it happening. I can literally talk about this topic for this long, and then somebody will say, "You know what? I think these kids just don't want to do it." And it's like, boom, boom. It ends the conversation, right? So why is Cassidy cleaning her bathroom instead of working on her thesis? Answer, procrastination. Boom, boom. Next slide. Next loser. Remember curious, compassionate, non-judgmental? She's not a loser. She's not bad. She's not lazy. She's not unmotivated. She spends hours on her hair and nails. She's very motivated. There's no such thing as procrastination. There's just choosing and choosing again. So if you see Penny throwing the football, you don't tell her she's lazy or unmotivated. You say, "Hey, Penny, look at you throwing a football, crossing midline, feeling that good sense with your friends." And yet there's something else you said you wanted. You said you wanted this degree. And she's like, "Oh, right." And she might choose again. "Hey, Cassidy, look at you cleaning your bathroom, getting that immediate squirt of dopamine right there in your head. Awesome. You did say there's something else you wanted, a degree in sociology. What you're doing now is inconsistent with that. Is there a different decision you want to make?" It's just choosing and choosing again.